Hare Krishna, welcome to our program. Our speaker of the day is Sriman Gaurang Darshan Prabhu. He has done his master's degree from the prestigious Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Prabhuji is a disciple of His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj, who is a senior disciple of His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. He is also a member of ISKCON Examination Board and takes classes on Srimad Bhagavatam, Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita and Vaishnav Etiquettes. He has written elaborate workbooks on Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita with which the students can dive into intricacies of these great scriptures. He is a compiler of many other educational booklets and magazines, thus helping the seekers of Bhagavat knowledge. In all, he is a living encyclopedia of scriptures, preaching the science all over the world, and who is exemplary and lives whatever he preaches. Come, let's hear him and try to imbibe the essence of scriptures as presented by him. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. We are discussing the story of Dhruva. Dhruva Maharaj was insulted by his stepmother Suruchi, and he was guided by his mother Suniti to worship Krishna, to fulfill whatever desires he has. And by the will of providence, Narada Muni met Dhruva and guided him to perform austerities and to perform bhakti to please Lord Vishnu. Dhruva went to Madhuvan on the banks of Yamuna. He performed tapasya for 6 months, and eventually the Supreme Lord Vishnu gave him darshan. And Dhruva Maharaj offered heartfelt prayers to the Lord. He was saying that, "My dear Lord, what I was desiring for was like broken pieces of glasses, but now I received diamonds in the form of your darshan, in the form of taste for your bhakti." So Dhruva Maharaj valued this process of devotional service much, much more than his previous material ambition to attain a position which is much superior to even Brahma also. It's such a lofty desire on the part of a small child, immature child, to sit in a position which is not even occupied by great-grandfather Brahma, who is the Supreme Personality within this universe. But somehow the process of devotional service that he has done under the guidance of Narada Muni has completely purified his aspirations, and as soon as Dhruva Maharaj received the darshan of Lord Vishnu, he was completely pure at heart. He did not aspire for anything else other than pure devotional service. So it is said in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, "Anyabhilashita shunyam jnana karmadi anavritam anukulyena krishnanu shilanam bhaktiruttama." Anya abhilashita shunyam. A person who is pursuing the spiritual path of pure devotional service, he should not have any material motivations. He should not have any personal desires or selfish ambitions behind his practice of bhakti. Anya abhilashita sunyam jnana karmadi anavritam. He should not be even aspiring for a lot of philosophical analytical knowledge as a product of devotional service. He should not be aspiring for any fruitive enjoyment also as a product of devotional service. So one may enjoy after performing bhakti. One may develop knowledge after performing bhakti, but that should not be the aspiration in the beginning when we are commencing to practice the process of bhakti. But Dhruva commenced his bhakti practice with a very serious material motivation. Now Dhruva is regretting for this. He offered prayers and he did not remind any of his previous desires to the Lord when the Lord gave him darshan. So after Dhruva Maharaj offered his prayers, Supreme Lord Vishnu started responding to him. He said, "My dear Dhruva, I already knew what you wanted. You began the process of bhakti with a desire to sit in a position which is superior to Brahma. I am aware of this. So now I give you these benedictions. The benedictions are, number one, you should rule the kingdom of your father for 36,000 years. You once had a desire to sit on your father's throne, father's lap, just like your stepbrother Uttama, but you did not have an opportunity to do it. So now I give you the benediction of ruling your father's kingdom for 36,000 years. After that, you also wanted a position which is superior to Brahma. Padam tribhuvanotkrishtam. Tribhuvana utkrishtam means of all the three planetary systems, of all the positions in the three planetary systems, what is the best position? That I am going to give you. So the Supreme Lord Vishnu tells Dhruva that you are going to occupy this Dhruva planet, this pole star, so which is directly my abode. I invite you to come to this pole star and then reside after ruling this earthly planet for 36,000 years. So the Supreme Lord fulfilled Dhruva's desire of sitting on father's throne. He also fulfilled Dhruva's desire to be in a position superior to Brahma's position also. Brahma resides in Satyaloka, which may be highest planet in this universe, but as far as the glory of the planet is concerned, the Supreme Lord's planet is much better than Brahma's planet. So the Supreme Lord Vishnu invited Dhruva to come to Dhruva's planet. That is called Dhruva Nakshatra or pole star on which the Supreme Lord Vishnu directly resides. And also the Supreme Lord Vishnu said, you can come back to my abode after fulfilling all your responsibilities in this material realm. So Dhruva was aspiring for a material benediction only, but here is Lord Vishnu who has given him a spiritual benediction, the topmost spiritual benediction of entering back to Godhead, of residing directly with Lord Vishnu in the spiritual realm. So this is the special kindness of Vishnu, that even if a devotee approaches the Lord with material desires, Lord will purify that devotee from all that material aspirations and give him spiritual benedictions. That's the speciality of the process of bhakti. And the Supreme Lord also acknowledged Dhruva's revengeful attitude towards his stepbrother Uttama and also stepmother Suruchi. When Suruchi insulted this Dhruva, little boy, 5-year-old boy, Dhruva became so angry towards her. He had revengeful attitude towards her. And also his brother Uttama, although he did not say anything to insult Dhruva, but still Uttama was sitting on the lap of his father and that position was aspired by Dhruva. Dhruva was quite disappointed that he could not sit like Uttama, and he had some little revengeful attitude towards Uttama also. So the Lord said, "Oh, my dear Dhruva, in future, once your brother Uttama will go for hunting into the forest and he will be killed by somebody there. He will be killed by Yaksha in the future. So your brother will be killed, and searching for your brother, your stepmother Suruchi will also go into the forest and she will be burnt in forest fire. So here is the greatest danger of Vaishnava Aparad." Dhruva was a pure Vaishnava. At this stage, 6 months back, Dhruva was not such an exalted devotee as he is now, but still Dhruva was a potential Vaishnava. If we unnecessarily offend a Vaishnava, a devotee, these are the repercussions. Here is the Supreme Lord Vishnu who is directly predicting the destruction of Uttama and Suruchi for being the cause of such great trouble and tribulation and anxiety and disturbance of Dhruva. So the power of Vaishnava Aparad is so great that one is unnecessarily put into so many troubles because of offending a Vaishnava. Dhruva was not a Vaishnava, great Vaishnava 6 months back, but still he was a potential Vaishnava. So Acharyas say that we should not unnecessarily insult anyone for that matter. Suruchi was very harsh and envious and angry towards Dhruva for no reason. Why should anyone hate other person? We should not hate anyone unnecessarily. If needed, if somebody does some mistake and if we are in a position to correct that person, uplift that person and encourage that person, we may speak a few things to correct him and then encourage him and uplift his consciousness. And if needed, we may become little strict with him. And if it is unavoidable, one may punish him also with a well-wishing heart. But none of these things should be done out of hatred. But here is Suruchi, who was unnecessarily having envy and hatred and anger towards a little boy for no reason. So why should anyone hate others? So if somebody unnecessarily hates another person, the repercussions will be like this. So here Vishnu directly predicted the death of Suruchi and Uttama for causing so much pain to the heart of Dhruva. And that is the importance that the Lord gives to his own devotee like Dhruva. And of course, we need to understand that after some time, after Dhruva Maharaj perfected his austerities and he became such a great Vaishnava and he went back to his kingdom, Suruchi again became favorable. Suruchi became very favorable to Dhruva and she started blessing Dhruva. Earlier, she was very harsh to Dhruva. After that, she welcomed Dhruva. So there was a transformation in the heart of Dhruva, now there is a transformation in the heart of Suruchi also. There is a transformation in the heart of Uttanapad also. So when one person performs bhakti under the inspiration of another bhakta, that creates a positive transformation in the lives of so many people. So here is Dhruva Maharaj who received all these benedictions. And after this, the Supreme Lord Vishnu just left from there on the back of his Garuda. And after benedicting Dhruva, when Vishnu left back to his abode, Dhruva Maharaj was not fully satisfied. Yes, he has done austerities for 6 months and he has attained the result of his austerities, but because he got some material benedictions, there was a lot of dissatisfaction in his heart. The reason for the dissatisfaction is one thing: his regret, his remorseful attitude, that once he had maintained some negative feelings towards his stepbrother and stepmother. So a genuine devotee, after maturing his practice of devotional service, he would regret for his past mistakes also. So when Dhruva became envious of Suruchi and Uttama, Dhruva did not have so much of knowledge and maturity. His mother told Dhruva, "My dear Dhruva, you should understand that whatever pain you receive in this world is only a result of your past deeds. And you should also not maintain any negative, envious thoughts towards anyone else." But Dhruva could not appreciate that suggestion. And Narada Muni also said, "Honor or dishonor will come to you only because of your own past deeds. Please understand this, Dhruva." Dhruva could not understand. So Dhruva could not accept the advice of Suniti. Dhruva could not accept the advice of Narada Muni earlier, the good advice of not maintaining hatred towards others. But he became very ambitious. But one thing that he has accepted from both of them, Narada and Suniti, was that if you perform bhakti unto Vishnu or Krishna, you will attain the fulfillment of all your desires. That one thing he has accepted. And he has performed bhakti with great determination, so that perfected his life. Now he has relinquished all this envious attitude towards his stepbrother and stepmother. So bhakti actually transforms the attitude of people. In the Bhagavatam 5th canto, there is a beautiful shloka. Yasyasti bhaktir bhagavatya kinchana sarvair gunaistatra samasate suraha harava bhaktasya kuto mahadguna manorathena satidhavato bahim. This shloka is spoken by Prahlad. He is another beautiful boy devotee. He was saying, yasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana. If someone performs akinchana bhakti, unalloyed devotional service without any material motivations, then what is the result? Sarvair gunaistatra samasate suraha. All the great qualities of great demigods also will manifest in such a person's personality. A devotee is endowed with all good qualities. Why a devotee is endowed with all good qualities? Because he performs bhakti of Krishna or Vishnu. It is bhakti that bestows all good qualities like humility, non-enviousness, satisfaction, tolerance, equanimity, and what else? Everything else. So we need to understand that bhakti bestows all good qualities. Here bhakti has transformed the heart of Dhruva, that he is now regretting for having some negative feelings towards his relatives in the past. So an honest person is a person who does not, it's not that an honest person will never commit any mistakes. By mistake, some mistake will happen always, but an honest person regrets for his mistake. He admits his mistake without justifying that. Oh, I have never done a mistake. He never says like that. There is a mistake on his part. He honestly regrets for it. He admits it. He makes an endeavor to rectify it. And he will never try to repeat the same mistake again. Uttanapada did a mistake towards Dhruva. He realized it. He regretted for it. He rectified it. And he never repeated it. And Dhruva also had made a mistake of being envious of Suruchi and Uttama. And now he is also regretting for it. Why did I unnecessarily have such material ambitions to enter a position which is better than Brahma, to have a revengeful attitude towards my brother and stepmother? So he was regretting, and with this deep regret, he returned back to the palace. So Dhruva Maharaj, when he was returning back to the palace, somebody went to Uttanapada and gave a message. Oh, Uttanapada, your son Dhruva, who was just a 5-year-old boy, he performed sincere bhakti unto Vishnu and he received the darshan of Vishnu, and now after successfully completing his mission of pleasing the Lord, he is coming back to your kingdom. Uttanapada's happiness knew no bounds. He was so happy. So he immediately awarded that messenger some necklace, some jewelry, and then he expressed his happiness, and with all entourage he went to receive Dhruva. Before even Dhruva reached the kingdom of Uttanapada, Uttanapada took all his soldiers and ministers and servants and 2 wives and 1 child to receive Dhruva. So when Dhruva Maharaj was being received like that, when Uttanapada was going along with all these people to receive Dhruva, Suniti boarded a palanquin. Suniti, the mother of Dhruva, she also became very happy. And everybody started glorifying Suniti. Oh, Suniti, you are such a wonderful mother. You have guided your son to perform bhakti unto Vishnu. And your son has become successful in pleasing Lord Vishnu. Now he is returning back. You are such a fortunate mother. You are such a great devotee, Vaishnava. And you have made your son also a great devotee. So, when Suniti was boarding this palanquin to receive Dhruva, she called Suruchi also. Suruchi, you can also come and sit in this palanquin. And you can bring your child, Uttama also, sit in the same palanquin. All 3 of us will sit in this palanquin and then go to receive Dhruva. So Suniti did not have any envy or revenge towards Suruchi. Although Suruchi was so envious of Suniti, Suniti was never envious of Suruchi. That is the difference between these 2 ladies. Because Suniti was a great devotee, she had tolerance, she had patience, she had satisfaction, she had the inner fulfillment coming from her practice of bhakti unto Krishna. But Suruchi did not have that. But somehow Suruchi was transformed later. So Suniti, broad-minded Suniti, allowed Suruchi to sit in her same palanquin, and she has completely forgiven Suruchi. So only because of you, Suruchi, my son left this palace, and 6 months I was away from my son, you are the villain. She never said like that. She just accommodated Suruchi also. So mistakes are common for everyone, but a broad-minded devotee will forgive the mistakes of wrongdoers. A wrongdoer's mistake cannot be approved, but a wrongdoer need not be neglected. So we may disapprove the mistakes of people, but we cannot disown them. So we don't have to break relationship with people who may perform something wrong, but we need to understand that because of the influence of material modes or some other past impressions or bad habits, people may commit some mistakes, so we should be forgiving to them. Here Suniti's good character, Suniti, because she is a devotee, she brought a transformation in the life of Dhruva. She immediately guided Dhruva Maharaj to perform bhakti, and he performed bhakti to Vishnu and he perfected his life. And because of her good manners, Uttanapada regretted for his mistake, and then he was transformed. And later, because of her tolerance and forgiveness, Suruchi was also transformed, and Uttama is a little boy, so there is no nothing objectionable in his overall demeanor. So because of one devotee, Suniti's devotional service, Suniti's bhakti, Suniti's Vaishnava qualities, there is a transformation, positive transformation in the lives of Dhruva, Uttanapada and Suruchi. When we are good, when we have these good qualities, Vaishnava qualities, we can positively influence others. When our consciousness is so poor, when we are envious, when we are having hatred and anger towards other people, how much positive impact we can have on others. So Suniti's positive attitude, Suniti's deep devotion to Krishna caused a transformation in so many people around. And this whole scene that we are discussing today is because of her devotion, because of her dedication. So we need to learn from this glorious woman Suniti how we can turn crisis in life into great opportunities to come closer to God. There was a crisis in Suniti's life, there was a crisis in Dhruva's life, but because of devotional service, because of bhakti unto Vishnu, they have turned the whole crisis into great opportunity to uplift their own consciousness, to uplift others' consciousness, like Uttanapada's consciousness and Suruchi's consciousness. And actually, by discussion of all this, our whole consciousness is also uplifted. That is the power of bhakti of even one devotee. So by taking inspiration from Suniti and Dhruva, let us all try to take some baby steps to come closer to God by sincerely practicing bhakti unto Vishnu or Krishna, following in the footsteps of great acharyas like Srila Prabhupada and many other Vaishnavas. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
For more such devotional programs, please watch Hare Krishna Television. To get this channel, please contact your cable or DTH operator. For more information, please call 8767 845-845.